And the results of a new survey about how the nation views New Orleans, now in. It was done by the University of New Orleans Survey Research Center. WDSU News Channel 6 anchor Tolson Alfonso is on your side live in the CBD now to tell us what surprises the survey uncovers. Tolson?
Well, good evening. 775 people took an online survey about what they thought of New Orleans. And for the most part, they said that it's not a nice place to visit post-Katrina.
The people, you know, who believe that we can't drink the water, that we're still underwater, that the restaurants aren't open, that type of thing jumped out at me.
All misperceptions that Dr. Robert Sims, the head of UNO's Survey Research Center, says need to be corrected.
Around the country, when people see footage of New Orleans, they're still seeing footage of New Orleans the day after Katrina with people standing on tops of roofs and underwater and so forth.
27% of the 775 people surveyed believe some parts of New Orleans are still underwater. 33% believe the French Quarter was one of the hardest hit areas and few businesses there have reopened. And 37% believe our water supply remains contaminated. As for locals,
so I think it's a challenge both to us, it's a challenge to the rest of the country to make sure that whether people love us or hate us, at least they have the facts, and they don't have the facts.
You know, the media doesn't usually want to show the restaurants are full and the French Quarter is great, and, you know, there's all kinds of things happening.
Now when the Saints whip them dirty birds.
Mary Beth Romig with the city's Convention and Visitors Bureau says they're doing everything to try and change the nation's perception.
Every big event that happens, every major convention that comes in, we create more and more ambassadors who can go out and tell that message to their neighbors and friends around the country and the world.
People who took the survey cite crime and corruption as a major problem in the Big Easy and believe corruption has played a large role in the slow pace of recovery. And nearly half of respondents blame the city's Katrina problems on the federal government. But on a positive note,
I mean, I was a little surprised that so many people seem willing to continue federal funding flowing into the area.
Now, it's interesting to note that 41% of the people that responded have never been to our city, and a third of them say they are not likely to visit within the next 2 years. On your side, live from the Central Business District, Tolson Alfonso, WDSU, News Channel 6.
All right, Tolson, and by the way, UNO held that survey between November 29th and December 4th. They plan to do another one next year to see if any of the views of our city will change.